In this example, I will derive the electrostatic attraction force between the plates of a parallel plate capacitor by using the fact that the force involved in our system is a conservative force. And for conservative forces, we can use always this principle that the force can be expressed as the position derivative of some potential energy. And to set up our capacitor, we need to spend some energy, and this energy is stored as electrostatic potential energy in the capacitor. And we know how to express this electrostatic energy if you have a constant charge. The charge does not change on the plates of the capacitor. Then in that case, from the electrostatic potential energy of the capacitor, we will be able to derive the force between the plates. First of all, the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with respect to its surface area and the distance between the plates is given by this expression. It is epsilon 0 times A divided by the distance between the plates. I keep the distance between the plates as a variable because the force between the plates will change with respect to this distance between the plates with respect to x. And we know that for a system which has all forces, for all forces of the system, if the forces are conservative forces, then we can express this force as the position derivative of a potential energy. And the potential energy in our case is the electrostatic potential energy of our capacitor. And we know how to express this potential energy in terms of the charge and the capacitance of the capacitor. And for a conservative force, this is the general principle that the force is in, let's say, x direction, the derivative of the potential minus derivative of the potential with respect to x. And let's do this for our system. So if you express the potential energy in terms of the charge and the capacitance, because the charge and the capacitance, if you keep the charges are constant, right, and we may express the potential energy in terms of the constant charge times the inverse of the capacitance, but the capacitance changes with the distance between the plates. So we have the potential energy 1/2 q squared, the x divided by epsilon 0 times a. And this should be a, okay. So the next is we apply this principle that the force may be expressed in terms of the derivative of the potential energy. And then you can easily find, if you take the derivative of u with respect to x, the distance between the plates, you get the force is equal to minus q squared divided by 2 epsilon 0 a. Well, how can we express, the next question is, how can we express this force in terms of the charge and the electric field between the plates? Well, beforehand, you may claim that if you know the charge inside an electric field E, then it is easy because the force is just equal to charge Q times E. But let's check this. We may always express this electric field between the parallel plate capacitor, and the electric field is the charge divided by the area of the plates, one of the plates, times epsilon 0. So we may express Q divided by A times epsilon 0 as the strength of the electric field. In that case, you will notice that the force is not equal to just Q times E, but 1/2 Q times E. As the strength of the force, it is 1/2 Q times the electric field strength between the plates. So we have here we have used the fact that E is equal to Q divided by epsilon 0 times A.